Hey everyone. In this video, I'm going to show you my favorite top five text formatter steps in Zapier. And so these are free steps you can use in Zapier and they don't count towards your task limit. So most accounts, all accounts have a task limit in Zapier. It starts at around 750, I think, per month, and you can go up to thousands and thousands. But depending on how many tasks you use in Zapier, that'll affect how much you pay. And the good thing about these formatter steps is that they're free in Zapier. They've made that change pretty recently, I think. And I think it's a great improvement. So basically what happens is you get a, in this example, I'm going to show you a form submission from JotForm. Check out my JotForm videos as well if you haven't seen those before, if you're not familiar with the form tool. And essentially some of the data coming in this form is not exactly as I want to see it and I need to use it. So I'm going to use these formatter steps to change some of that data. So the formatter steps I'm going to show you are the capitalized text in formatter, the split text, the replace text, extract phone, and finally the convert to ASCII to clean up, you know, some input when the text is a bit different than what your platform might accept. And so let's start with this form. So this form looks like this very simple form I've built in JotForm for free. And then I've got a first submission here is from Jan, and you can see Jan, he's got a Polish surname, which my CRM or my spreadsheet that I'm going to add the detail into doesn't have the ability, unfortunately, to accept some of these letters. So I've got to clean up or change those letters. The email that he's added in here, and this is formatted from maybe from some other system, let's say, if we use our imagination, has this @_@. And we want to replace that, obviously, with a normal email @ symbol. And then he's got his company, Lucky Co., and then the phone number. He hasn't added in the number here, and we've just got text, which has the number included in it. So you might have some system that is more like a comment or something like that, where you want to extract the text, you want to extract the phone number from that text. And so this is kind of a created example here. Obviously, if you could choose, you would prefer to have a form that has a first name and a last name, and you would obviously also prefer to have a form that only accepts email formatted the correct way, and also a form which just has a phone number field rather than a text field, so you can accept this. And you can do all that in HubSpot, in JotForm, and most form builders, but I've created this kind of fake annoying form just as an example in case you're using a tool which doesn't format things correctly, and that's why we're using Zapier to fix the formatting. So, and ultimately we want to get this data cleaned up and into this simple Google sheet here as well. So that's what we're going to do in this short video. And so we've got this new submission in Zapier. So the trigger I've set up here is JotForm. Event is a new submission. I've selected my form here, and then I've done a test and gotten this first answer from Jan into this form like that. So we're going to continue with that record. Then I've added the next step is the formatter step, and the event, you can choose four different formatters in Zapier, or sort of categorizations. I've already done a video on date time, so feel free to check that out. And this one we're talking about today is text, and then in the future I will probably do numbers or utilities, maybe both of them as well. So today I'm going to show you my top five, and I think the top five most useful text formatters, and you know, maybe do some other ones in the future as well. So the first one we're going to do is capitalize the text. So let's say the form submission he's actually filled this in, and rather than typing in his name like this, for some reason he's done all caps for his first name and lowercase for his surname, or maybe that's all caps, or maybe it's all lowercase, or maybe some countries and subcultures, they write their surname in all caps as well. So let's imagine we want to get this so that the first letter is capital like this and the rest is lowercase, so we don't have this kind of uneven name like this. So let's go back into Zapier. I'm going to just pull that second submission as a test. I've just submitted a second form submission with the first name, last name, the all caps version. Let's have a look and see like this. And so we were going to use this first formatter step to fix that up. So let's go back here. So we've got that text capitalize, and then we add in the full name like this. And then if we test this step, we can see that now it's fixed up that great. And now the next step we need to do, we want to split that into first name and last name as separate data points here. So we're going to say, we're going to add the formatter step, text again. We choose transform split text. And then we're going to put in that regular capitalized version that we've just cleaned up there. And we're going to say that the separator should be the space. So you can see here, if you click on more, that the default is actually space. You don't even need to type this in, but you can. And also you can select, click this link, and you can see some of the other options that you can add in if you need to split by some other value, you know, for example, new lines or tabs, things like that. We're going to leave it as blank because we're going to use space. And then what we want to do is we want to either get the first name, the second name, or we can even pull out all of them as separate fields or line items. We're going to do separate fields, and then we can click next, and then we can test, and then we have them as separate there, like so. Now we want to replace the text in the formatter, and we want to replace the text of the email address. So the same again, event is text, formatter step, event text, transform is replace, and then we're going to add in that email address that we've got here with the at, where we have the underscore at underscore, and we're going to say the same, and we want to replace that with the at. So obviously this is going to do this every single time someone submits the job form. So this is not likely that this is happening for you, but you might have another tool, another platform, which does always have the wrong data coming in because of the way that platform is formatting the data. And so maybe some other example like this, but basically you're saying whenever something exists in that data, replace it with something else that may be sort of cleaning it up for you. So let's try this. We test that step. Now we have a functional email address that looks good. And then the next one is we're going to say, we're going to fix up the phone. We're going to try and pull out that phone text. So again, formatter, event is text. We add in that phone number field, which is down here. We've got all this data here. We don't want that. We just want the phone number. So we're going to extract the phone number. We can select the phone number format if we have one that's regular. I'm going to click international. Let's see how it does it. And then we'll test this step. Cool. And it's pulled out just the number from that. So now we can continue. And then the last thing we want to do is we're going to fix up this, the text, the name. So I'll get rid of this example here. And we're going to put in split text and the surname like this. And we're going to clean that up. Unfortunately, for the Polish name, it's not going to be Polish, the Polish, correct Polish spelling anymore. It's going to be replaced with the English letters, which are obviously different. But unfortunately, some systems don't have very good support for different letters, different alphabets, etc. So if you do need to pull out and change some of the letters, let's say remove some of the extra accents, or if you need to clean up some other kind of formatting that may have maybe problems when you're using special characters, this is the step to use for that. This convert to ASCII. So now we have the English letters version of this Polish name. We can click continue, and now we can create our spreadsheet row. Okay, and now I'm going to add in our results. So we've got the split text first name, split text second name, email, and obviously this is just a made up version to demonstrate some of the features of the formatter step, but it really depends on your specific cases. So you'll need to use kind of your imagination a little bit for some of these examples here, because you probably wouldn't have a specific case like this, but this does just give you some to show you a little bit more about how you can use some of the features in the formatter function of Zapier. And there's also, this is kind of like a beginner, I guess, but there's also a lot more that you can do with this as well in terms of more complicated things. So yeah, and we did clean up or change the last name, didn't we? I won't say clean up, but we changed it to English. So let's grab that English version, click continue. We can test that step, and we jump in, and here we have it. I think something good to keep in mind is that when we've added into Google Sheets, it's assumed it's a number. And so it's gotten rid of the zero there. Let's try that text again. Let's try that test again here. And then we've got these results. Let's have a look. Cool. Now it's correct. It's got the zero there. So it's always important to test and make sure that you're not going to have a whole lot of errors or missed data if it's not set up correctly. Now that's all done. Now we can click publish and we can take it into the real world and use this in your examples as well. So let me know if this is useful for you. Jump down in the comments and add some information about any cases you've got, any problems you've faced. I'd love to go into some more specific detail in some future videos. So feel free to share. And if this is useful for you, like the video and feel free to subscribe as well if you want to see more videos like this in the future. So thanks very much for watching and look forward to seeing you in the next one. Cheers.